Some days your NFL team is always good. You will not miss a minute of action. Enjoy wings, salads, sandwiches, and more as your teams take the field. Come in and fan up while enjoying the variety of beers on tap from kickoff to the final whistle. Located at 417 Rieger Drive in Williston, North Dakota, football lives here. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beers, sports.
American State Bank and Trust Company of Williston is proud to support area student activities. We salute the dedication of all students involved in sports and other extracurricular school activities. Your hard work and dedication shows in the gym, on the field, and in the classroom. ASB has accounts and services to fit a student's busy lifestyle, too. Check them out at asbt.com. Here to make our community better? That's American State Bank and Trust Company. Member FDIC.
Final 2 seconds here of the first media timeout of the game. Tetons are on top, 21-13 here on the American State Bank scoreboard. May have changed the score there. We'll have to see if we can't get that at some point to see if they took a point away from Mystics. Called a 3 instead of a 2, or a 2 instead of a 3. Right now, it will be Teton ball underneath their own basket. They're up 21-13 on the American State Bank scoreboard. It'll be Ingot, Sterling, Massey, Olson, and Leon into the game for the Tetons. They're along the post. Calling for action is Ingot. Flying out, up on top, it'll go to Massey. They'll get it and set up the half-court set. Ingot coming up on top to grab the ball. Flips it over to Olson. Pump fake, back to Massey. Massey holding on, Leon up on top, looking to take Brent. He's going to drive, gets underneath, swing pass to Olson, up on top to Ingot. Ingot's going to go, and he'll be blocked by Elmagary, who's freshly into the game. Pass back out, goes the Mystics, bringing it back up. Elmagary's going to bring it in. Proctor also back into the game for the Mystics. He came in for Strand. Bozeman on the high post, gets it underneath to Elmagary. He flips it up, no good. Good defense by Leon. Long pass from Ingot out to Olsen. He'll pull it back up. Tyson grabs it, flips it to Massey. Works his way around. Massey looking to drive. He's going to take a bump, and that'll be on Proctor. So Proctor picks up his first personal first team, and Tyler Bass is going to be coming into the game for Richard Massey at the next stop. Signal from the scores table. Massey at the stripe for a pair. Looking to extend the Teton lead out to 10. If he can knock down both of them, first one on the way is going to be up and good. The Tetons now up by 9 points. It's Massey at the stripe for his second of two. That one rims in and out, no good. It's going to be out of bounds. They're going to say it's off of Freedom Leon. So that'll pull Massey out of the game and bring in Tyler Best. So now, for the five starters and for Williston State, holding on to a 9-point lead, 22-13. Long pass going to go to Elmagary on the far wing. Bounce pass back up on top. It'll go for the T-top, for the Mystics. Elmagary looking, surveying, gives it to Bozeman on the high post. Pump fake on Sterling. They find Elmagary, a little mismatch, back to Bozeman. He pulls the trigger from the elbow, and up and good. Kenneth Bozeman's having a big game. He's single-handedly keeping the Mystics in this one, as we now have a scoreboard malfunction. Sterling has it up on top of the perimeter. Olson pulls the trigger from three. Off the mark, no good. Long rebound's going to be taken by Strand. Two on, two break. Strand taking Ingot. Long, high rebound, arcing hook shot up and in. That'll make it now 22-17. Back up the court comes Tyson Ingot. Gets it to Tyler Best. Teton still holding on to their 5-point advantage. Bounce pass underneath to Sterling. Back out to Ingot. Wide open for three is Ingot. Got it to go. Tyson Ingot joining the 3-point party here for the Tetons. Back up to an 8-point advantage. Proctor gets the ball, flips it over to Bozeman on top, on the wing now, driving on Sterling, flips it underneath, going to be blocked from behind by Leon, and they're going to call a foul on Freedom Leon, and that's going to send Hussein Elmagary to the stripe for a pair of free throws with 10:08 left to go. Third team foul on the Tetons, just the first personal on Leon. Elmagary at the stripe for his first. That is going to be up and good. 25-18 now on the American State Bank scoreboard. We'll have one more to go from the stripe. Next one on the way. That one is good as well. Perfect 2 for 2 from the line. 6-point lead for Williston State. Ingett calling the play as he marches it up the court for the Tetons. Williston State coming out strong offensively. 10 minutes left to go. Sterling holds on to it, kicks it off to Leon, and Leon's going to be called for the travel. Turnover gives it back to the Mystics, who will have a chance to chip away at the lead. Tetons have led by as many as 9 points in the game. That'll be some full-court press being put on by Williston State. Inbound pass goes to Proctor. Tetons bail out of the press as Proctor will be picked up by Ingett. Racing towards it. Ingett goes with a gamble. Defense was able to recover in time. Up on top to Strand. Out of the near wing. Bozeman calling it court on the elbow. Mystics looking to go the high-low post game. Leon pushes Elmagary off the low post area. Force it down onto Bozeman. Bozeman working on Sterling. Good block by Sterling, and there's going to be a jump ball called. Rex Sterling with the good defensive awareness. And that is the ball back to Williston State here at 9:29 left to go in the first. Only one team foul on the Mystics so far through the first 10.5 minutes of play. Three on Williston State. Dyson Ingett working, crossing over, picks up a screen from Sterling. He's going to get onto the post area, lose a handle on it. It'll be picked up by Strand. Another turnover for Williston State. Ingett harassing Strand down the court. He'll cross over on the perimeter. Now Ingett being just an absolute pest. Open three coming from Proctor. That's going to be no good. A little bit of a defensive breakdown that worked out for Williston State. Leon driving baseline. He'll be trying to flip it up. He took a bump, but no call. Back comes Proctor. He's going to work his way through traffic, and that's going to be a quick second foul on Leon. That'll be his second personal, and he'll be checked out of the game. Makai Marks will come back in. 8:54 left to go in the first half. Tetons still up by six. Coming back, set to inbound the ball. Bader will get it up on top to Proctor. Crosses over to Elmagary on the perimeter. Surveying, waiting, gets it on the high post to Bozeman. 15-footer up, no good. Sterling with the board, gets it off to Ingett, looks to push up the court. Tetons don't have numbers. Ingett will hand it off to Olsen on the wing. Little picky move, gets it up to Sterling. Rex Sterling for three, in and out, no good. Elmagary pulls down the board. 8.5 left to go. Elmagary now running the point. And just about another steal from Ingett into the hands of Strand it goes, trying to get it again to Bozeman on the high post. Up on top to Proctor. Elmagary calling for it on the post extended. He's going to go for a little rip-through move. No good. Proctor comes down with it, and he'll be blocked by Sterling. Rex Sterling comes down to the board. Long pass up to Marks. Marks loses the handle. Tetons had a chance for a highlight play. And there'll be a long pass into the corner for Best. Up on top to Marks. Get it to Sterling. Sterling, spin move. Double clutch, puts it up. No good. Elmagary comes down to the board. Sterling has had some tough sledding down to the post. They've given lots of attention down to him. Cam Dowst and Ben Yombi set to come in on the next stop for the Tetons. Closing in on 7.5 minutes left to go. Scoring has stalled for both teams a little bit throughout the last couple minutes. 6-point lead for Williston State, 21-19. Bozeman has it up on top. Elmagary had it poked away by Sterling. They're going to call it another ticky foul on Rex Sterling, who picked up his second with 7:34. And in comes Cam Dowse. And with Sterling picking up his second, that'll bring back in some more Mystics. Bringing back in Isaiah Davis will go in for Bozeman. And going out of the game is Bader. And coming back in is going to be Brown. Inbound play goes to Davis. He gets it to Elmagary on the free throw line. Working on Best. Flips it underneath to Davis. Davis corralled. Double clutch. He's going to put it up. He'll be blocked. Elmagary gets the rebound. Puts it up. That's no good. Yami comes away with it. Working his way through traffic. Only Strand between him and the bucket. Flips it up and in. And Yami with the good bucket to put it up for 2 points. Oh, Yami with a big-time play there for Williston State. Extends the lead back out 27-19. Bounce pass, Brown, stolen away by Dowse. He'll find a guard, gets it off to Yami. Has Marks. Here comes a run out by Makai Marks, and he's going to be fouled on the dunk by Raymond Brown. Rattles out of the rim, so that'll be Makai Marks going to the stripe for a pair. Marks trying for a crushing blow on that outlet pass, and there'll be an under 7 minute timeout for the game. It's another media timeout, last of the half. We'll have 6:57 left to go in the half. Tetons up by 8 with Marks at the line for 2. We'll be back in 1 minute.
Your education shouldn't mean putting your life on hold. Wherever you are in life, Williston State College has you covered. With our flexible and convenient associate and associate of applied science programs, you can take classes fully online to meet the needs of your lifestyle. With 13 CTE and 15 academic programs to choose from, our dedicated faculty are here to help you achieve your career goals. Visit WillistonState.edu/apply or call 701-774-4200 to learn more. Williston State College, where the people make the difference.
So you need a new vehicle. You've done your homework, and a new Honda would be perfect. Reliable, fuel efficient, stylish, perfect. But where do you go? Why not your hometown Honda dealer, Ryan Honda at Ryan Motors in Williston? We have a nice selection of affordable new Hondas, and when it comes time for service, Ryan Honda's authorized Honda Service Center will keep your Honda running its best for years. Come see us today, your full-service hometown Honda dealership, Ryan Honda at Ryan Motors in Williston, or shop RyanHonda.net.
Basketball on 660 Keys News Radio. Mackay March at the stripe for Williston State. Checking into the game for the Tetons is going to be Brayden Feller. So Feller, March, Best, Dowd, and Yabby on the court for the Tetons. Garrett Bader back into the game as March knocks down his first of two. Bader back in for Proctor. March extends the lead up now 28-19. He'll have one more from the stripe. Second one on the way, and that one's going to be no good. Tipped out by Yambi. Best comes away with the rebound. Marks back up to Best. Takes a couple of hard dribbles back to Marks. He'll find Feller on the wing. Works his way back up on top. Hands it off to Yambi. Looking to work his way down low. Off to Dowse. Baseline jumper on the way. That'll be up and over everything. Long rebound, a chance, and finally comes away with it is Strand. Couple of Tetons collide into each other. Here comes an open three-pointer from Bader. Off the mark, no good. Tipped out back to Bader. He'll try to find Proctor underneath, and bounce pass to Elmagary, doesn't go anywhere. Pulling it back out is Strand to Elmagary on the low post. Turnaround jumper up and good for Elmagary. And that'll be two more points now, 28-21. Back up the court come the Tetons, looking to work their way around. Feller up on top to Yambi. He's going to look to drive. He's going to flip it out to Marks from the three. Pump fake, no, nothing there. Back out to Feller, guarded by Davis. Feller on the drive. Step back jumper over the top of Davis. No good. Tipped around by Dowse. But come away with it is Strand. And he's been a pest on the defensive boards. He's anything that's being tipped down has gone right to him. There goes up now to Strand on the far wing. Pack paint for the Mystics. They get underneath to Elmagary. And there's going to be a hold called on Dowse. That's going to be the 16th foul on the Tetons with 5:44 left to go. Their last foul to give here in the first half. Just two team fouls on the Mystics. So first one on Cam Dowse, and it'll be the Mystics inbounding the ball. They'll get a fresh 20 on the shot clock. Gavin Strouds inbounding the ball from underneath his own basket. Tetons packing the paint, not wanting to allow anything easy. Elmagary, little floater up, no good. And we have put back by Strand, and no good on that one. Best comes down to the rebound. Push it up to Feller. Feller had a window to get to Dowse, but too close to trying to thread the needle as they bring it back up to Yambi. Push his way to the near wing. Yambi, a little shimmy to shake. There's a Dowse screen, and Yambi with a nice mid-range jumper from the charity stripe. Gets it up and in. Tetons back up by 9, one shy of their largest lead of the game. Proctor off the court for the Mystics. He's going to look to drive. Flips it back to Elmagary from the free throw line. Underneath to Davis. He's going to be bumped out on the top of the perimeter. Strand for three. Knocks it down. Gavin Strand with a much-needed dribble for the Mystics. Back down to a 6-point Teton lead. Yambi back up the court. Richard Massey set to check in. Best back up to Yambi, who takes off on the drive to Feller in the corner. Feller waiting. Bullet pass to Marks. Catch and shoot on the way. Up no good. Pulled down by Proctor. Back come the Mystics. 4:44 left to go in the first, and Proctor absolutely barrels over Yambi. No call either way, and there's going to be another three-pointer wide open. No good. Tipped out, and bodies colliding all over the place, and finally into the hands of Isaiah Davis, who puts the alley-oop layup up and in. Massey now going to be joined by Sterling, 30-26. Mystics trying to climb back into this one. They've trailed by as many as 10 points. Best three-pointer to answer. That one will be off. No good. Elmagary with the rebound for the Mystics. They have a chance to bring it back to a one-possession game this trip up the court. Elmagary calling for action. Now Will Olson's at the scores table set to come back in. Tetons floundering a little bit on the offensive end. A low running hook shot up, no good. Another offensive rebound. Left shot by Elmagary, no good. And Bader with the rebound up on top again to Strand for a three-pointer. That's no good. Long rebound will go out of bounds. The Tetons will get some reserves to come into the court. And we'll have a Teton timeout holding on to a four-point 30-26 lead with 3:50 left to go. We'll see if it's a long one or a short. It's just going to be a short one. We'll be back in 30 seconds.
When you're looking for a new or a different home, seek the counsel of the professionals at Basin Brokers. Basin Brokers has offices in Plentywood, Montana, Watford City, and Williston. The realtors at Basin Brokers know the market and will help you find the home that fits your requirements and budget. They're happy to answer all your questions about the area. The real estate office you want to know is Basin Brokers in Watford City, Plentywood, and Williston. Find them online at basinbrokers.com.
Basketball on 660 Keys News Radio. Tetons have the ball up by four with 3:50 left to go in the first half, 30-26. And now coming back out on the floor is Bismarck State and the Mystics. Tetons, Benyami bringing it up, gets it off to Tyler Best. Best looking for Olsen, who's curling around the top of the perimeter. Nothing there. Bounce pass underneath to Sterling. Working on Elmagary. Good move. Gets into his chest. Going to lose the ball underneath. Scramble for it. And finally picked up by Proctor. And they're going to call a foul on Sterling, who picks up another very touch foul. So Sterling to pick up his third. And Sterling can't believe it as he'll be coming out of the game. Freedom Leon checking in. So Leon, when Cam Dowse was out with the flu, is playing that reserve center role. He'll come in to do that against a very good Davis. As at the stripe for a 1-1 is Alex Proctor. First one on the way is going to be up and in. That'll make it now a three-point game, 30-27. Chance to make it a two-pointer. If he can knock down the second of two, second one on the way, it'll be in and out, no good. Rebound by the Tetons. Bounce pass up to Best. Work his way to the free throw line to Massey. Back to Best. Finds Yambi into the corner for Olsen. Olsen holding, waiting. High post to Leon. Working on Elmagary. Out to Olsen. Open three on the way. Will Olsen knocks it down. Much needed bucket for the Tetons. That'll extend it back out to 6 points, 33-27. Tetons, a little bit of full court press coming. Olsen on Proctor. He'll push Proctor now as he looks to drive down low. He's going to go player up and over the top of Leon. A little bit of a defensive breakdown for the Tetons that allowed Proctor to go coast to coast to put it in. 33-29. Tetons looking to hold on to their lead and extend it out here before half. Under 3 minutes left to go. Yabi out to Massey. Massey working, gets it over to Olsen. Olsen, big pump fake, get the elbow up on top to Massey. Three-pointer on the way from Massey. No good. And he tipped out of bounds. Last touch by Elmagary and the Mystics. And the Mystics thought that was all theirs. And Coach Kevin Rice for Bismarck State not happy about that decision from the officials. It'll be Teton ball underneath their own basket. Fresh 20 on the shot clock. Yabi looking to inbound. Up on top, it'll go to Massey. He'll push it to the top of the perimeter. Finds Best, who works his way back up. Over to Olsen. Looking down low. Nothing available. Swings it up to Massey. Calls for a high screen from Leon. Pick and roll. Into the corner. Best. Three-pointer on the way. Tyler Best with another triple. And that will make it now a seven-point lead as the Tetons. We're going to get a little more cushion before the break. 2:15 and counting. Alex Proctor working up. Tyson Ingett set to check in for the Tetons. Proctor across the timeline. Davis calling for it up on top. Olsen there in his face. Underneath to Elmagary. Working on Leon. And that's going to be a missed shot by Elmagary. And Strand will take down Best. It'll be just a third team foul on the Mystics here in the first half. Seven on the Tetons. Ingett's going to be coming into the game for Will Olsen. So a rare chance when you have both Ingett and Yambi on the court for the Tetons. This may allow Ben Yambi to work more as the two guard. Yambi bringing it up on top of the perimeter. Ingett flashes out to the far wing. Yambi on top calling for a Leon screen. Good screen by Leon out to Ingett. He drives in, kicks it up on top to Yambi. Pulls up just inside the perimeter. Up, no good. Davis with the rebound, loses the handle on it. He dribbles out, he picks it back up, continues his drive. ingot over to Proctor, shuffles his feet, spin moves. He's going to go up and hoop, and the harm, they get it on Yabi. And the Mystics are getting all sorts of things to drop here in the second half. That big shot by Proctor, who has been a big boon off the bench for the Mystics, will make it now 36-31, back to a five-point game. Chance to cut it down to four if he can knock down the three-point play. That foul on Yabi is just his first. Free throw is going to be up and good. Proctor knocks down the shot, and out of the game comes Yabi. In comes Brady Feller. Ingot pushing up the court, gets the play call from Coach Herman. Best back to Ingot. On top of the perimeter, over to Leon, back to Feller. Feller's had a hot hand. He's going to drive on Bader, kicks it back out to Best, curls around. Best gets under, over the top, up, no good. Tipped out, pulled down by Bader, and back come the Mystics. Chance to cut it to a one-possession game. He'll cross the timeline, call a timeout with 1:17 left to go in the first half. So the Tetons have held the lead since it was 2-2, and looking to do so for the remaining 1 minute 17 seconds. It's a short one. We'll take a short one as well. Back in half a minute.
Of all your choices for a financial institution, clearly the best is the West. Western Cooperative Credit Union is money done the Western way. WCCU provides you with good old-fashioned Western hospitality every time you walk through our door. We treat you like neighbors ought to treat each other, because that's just who we are, neighbors. So head west. You'll know you're here when you see the bison on our sign. Join the herd at Western Cooperative Credit Union, federally insured by NCUA.
Good defense by Richard, but it gets the soft touch by Davis. That'll make it a two-point game. 36-34. Tetons need a bucket and a stop here before half. Best back to Ingot. Working his way around, has it. No. Ingot takes it into the corner. A little okey-doke up on top to Feller for three from the top. Up no good. And it'll be taken away from Leon by Elmagary. He'll get it off to Bader. And Tetons look now to get a stop chance for the Mystics to tie the game or take the lead here in the remaining 35 seconds. 19 on the shot clock. Bader has it on the near wing. Up on top to Proctor. He kicks it over to Strand on the far wing. Milking time off the clock. Over to Bader from the corner for three. And Garrett Bader knocks it down. And that will be a long three-pointer to put the Mystics up by one. And the Tetons are going to take a timeout. That'll make it a one-point Mystic lead, their first lead of the game. We have 17 seconds left to go before the half hits. We're waiting to see if Coach Herman calls a long one or a short one. It's going to be a short one. We'll be back in another 30 seconds.
Coke Zero Sugar tastes so good, people will take a taste any way they can. You never know when your best friend will lunge across a table and grab for it. A stranger could subtly swipe it, or your little brother might just ask for one too many sips. So no matter what you're doing or who you're with, while you're enjoying a Coke Zero Sugar, be ready to protect it at all times. Because one sip begs the question, is this the best Coke ever? Take a taste and see.
On top, Tetons at one point at a 10-point lead. Inbound play coming for Williston State. Ingot gets it into Massey. Back to Tyson Ingot on the far wing. Looking a little hesitation dribble. He'll pull back out. Looking for the drive now. He's going to stop on the paint. Give and go, and it's going to be thrown just about safe from going out of bounds. They get it up, and it's going to be no good. Davis with the rebound. Best comes away with it, and the Tetons avoid disaster at the buzzer with a turnover. And they'll head into halftime down by 1 point. This one is good as advertised. The Mystics climbing back in and taking a lead just before halftime. So the Tetons now having to go make some halftime adjustments. And with Rex Sterling out with three fouls, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments they can make 15 minutes up on the clock. We're going to take a 7-minute timeout. We can run down to the scores table, get the official stats from halftime. We'll be back for the halftime breakdown here from Williston in 7 minutes.
You don't have to drive hundreds of miles to get a great deal on a new or used vehicle. Price sells cars at Williston Auto. We're in the business of beating the deal from any dealer. Go ahead, shop around from Bismarck to Billings. Then bring us their best deal. We'll squish it like a bug and beat it like a rented mule. No animals or insects were injured while making this commercial. Price sells cars at Williston Auto and WillistonAuto.com. See dealer for details.
G&G Pharmacy, an independent, locally owned retail pharmacy committed to providing you top-notch customer service from their friendly, fast, and knowledgeable staff. Open 7 days a week. G&G Pharmacy offers the convenience of a drive-through window and a traditional retail store. Melissa and Doug toys available at their downtown service drug location. And no more wondering when your prescription's ready. Use the mobile app or receive a text message when it's ready from G&G Pharmacy. 572-RXRX. That's 572-7979.
I got the windows rolled down, and I'm cruising these back roads on the outskirts of town. And I can feel the wind blowing, hear the big engines whine. When I'm cruising these back roads, all my troubles are behind. Well, when I woke up this morning, well, I took me a look outside. It was plain to see it was one of those days that I made for taking a ride. So I went downstairs, cleared my head with coffee and cigarettes. And when it hit me right there, then my mind was set. Well, I phoned work and told them they're gonna be a man short today. I got the sunny day blues, that's only one thing that's gonna make them go away. So I went the windows roll down, and I'm cruising these back roads on the outskirts of town. Well, I can feel the wind blowing and hear the big engines whine. When I'm cruising these back roads, all my troubles are behind. Big engine wide. When I'm cruising these back roads, all my troubles are behind. I got the radio blasting, I got the windows rolled down, and I'm cruising these back roads on the outskirts of town. And I can feel the wind blowing, hear the big engine wide.
TV diet lies. Good morning, honey. Go to work, make up, try to keep the balance up between love and money. She used to tie her hair up in ribbons and bows, sign her letters with X's and O's. Got a picture of her mama in heels and pearls. She's trying to make it in her daddy's world. She's an American girl. American girl.
chance. Mama needs romance and a living maid. Fix the sink, mow the yard, really isn't all that hard if you get paid. She used to tie her hair up in ribbons and bows, sign her letters with X's and O's. Got a picture of her mama in heels and pearls. She's trying to make it in her daddy's world. An American girl, an American girl. Well, she's got her God and she's got good wine.
American State Bank and Trust Company of Williston is proud to support area student activities. We salute the dedication of all students involved in sports and other extracurricular school activities. Your hard work and dedication shows in the gym, on the field, and in the classroom. ASB has accounts and services to fit a student's busy lifestyle, too. Check them out at asbt.com. Here to make our community better? That's American State Bank and Trust Company. Member FDIC.
By 137-36, and it was a big run by the Mystics. The Tetons at one point were up by 9 points. That was with 11:22 left to go in the second quarter. They brought it back out to 8 points. Never got brought down between then and now, but it's a 1 point lead by the Mystics at the half. Their largest and only lead of the game. They got that in with 25 seconds left to go in the game. Looking at the stats, starting off with Bismarck State, Kenneth Bozeman leading the way, and he's leading all scorers at halftime with 11 points. 7 points coming in from Isaiah Davis, 6 from Alex Proctor, 4 in from Raymond Brown, 3 from Garrett Bader, 2 from Gavin Strand, and 2 from Hussein Alighieri. Shooting in the first half for the Mystics, they were 15 of 33 from the field, 2 of 6 from deep, and 3 of 4 from the line. Leading the way in rebounding is Alighieri. He has 6 rebounds at the break, 5 defensive, 1 offensive, 19 overall rebounds for the Mystics, 13 defensive, 6 offensive rebounds, 8 assists on those 15 made plays, 4 steals, 4 blocks, 5 turnovers, and just 2 personal fouls in the game, one on Brown and one on Proctor. Looking at the Teton, they're led in scoring by Tyler Best. He has 9 points, all from beyond the arc, as the Mystics have been really packing the paint and have not been allowing the Tetons to get working down low, as the Tetons still looking to get Rex Sterling going. He has just 2 points at the break. And leading the way, Tyler Best with 9. 8 points coming in from Brady Feller. 5 points from Tyson Ingett, 4 from Makai Marks and Ben Yombi, 3 from Will Olson, 2 in from Rex Sterling, and 1 point from Richard Massey. Shooting for the Tetons, they went 12 of 32 from the field for 40%, 8 of 18 from beyond the arc for 44%, and just 2 of 4 from the line. Only a couple trips to the line for Williston State, as they have been absorbing lots of contact. It's been a physical one. the Tetons. In a little bit of foul trouble with Sterling picking up three. Tetons leading the way in rebounding. Sterling has six in the game, four defensive, two offensive. Only 13 rebounds at the break for the Tetons, nine defensive rebounds, four offensive rebounds, eight assists on their 13 made buckets, four steals, including the first play of the game, which Tyson Ingett picked off a pass and took it the distance for a layup to have the Tetons jump out 2-0. Six turnovers for Williston State and eight personal fouls in that first half. Points in the paint, Bismarck 20, Tetons only with six. Points off of turnovers, Mystic 7, Tetons 3. Second chance points, 5-4 Tetons. Points from the bench, 13-10 Williston State. There was one tie at 2-2 and one lead change, and that came with 25 seconds left to go when the Mystics knocked down a three-pointer to take a one-point lead. Tetons in the layup line, out getting warmed up. Mystics are also out there. We have 4 minutes left to go before we get underway for half number two. We're going to step aside for a final three-minute timeout. When we come back, we'll get you going and started for what should be a fantastic second half here from the Well in Williston. We'll be back in 3 minutes.
Of all your choices for a financial institution, clearly the best is the West. Western Cooperative Credit Union is money done the Western way. WCCU provides you with good old-fashioned Western hospitality every time you walk through our door. We treat you like neighbors ought to treat each other, because that's just who we are, neighbors. So head west. You'll know you're here when you see the bison on our side. Join the herd at Western Cooperative Credit Union, federally insured by NCUA.
McDonald's of Williston is proud to support all the Williston State Teton athletic teams and would like to wish them success this season. McDonald's would like to thank the community of Williston and the surrounding area for your patronage over the years. Hey, the next time you're in town, stop by McDonald's for a great meal or a quick snack. McDonald's of Williston. Breakfast, lunch, or dessert, come on into McDonald's of Williston. Proud to be a part of Teton Athletics and proud to be part of the Williston community.
Coke Zero Sugar tastes so good, people will take a taste any way they can. You never know when your best friend will lunge across a table and grab for it. A stranger could subtly swipe it, or your little brother might just ask for one too many sips. So no matter what you're doing or who you're with, while you're enjoying a Coke Zero Sugar, be ready to protect it at all times, because one sip begs the question, is this the best Coke ever? Take a taste and see.
You don't have to drive hundreds of miles to get a great deal on a new or used vehicle. Price sells cars at Williston Auto. We're in the business of beating the deal from any dealer. Go ahead, shop around from Bismarck to Billings. Then bring us their best deal. We'll squish it like a bug and beat it like a rented mule. No animals or insects were injured while making this commercial. Price sells cars at Williston Auto and WillistonAuto.com. See dealer.
G&G Pharmacy, an independent, locally owned retail pharmacy committed to providing you top-notch customer service from their friendly, fast, and knowledgeable staff. Open 7 days a week. G&G Pharmacy offers the convenience of a drive-through window and a traditional retail store. Melissa and Doug Toys available at their downtown service truck location. And no more wondering when your prescription's ready. Use the mobile app or receive a text message when it's ready from G&G Pharmacy. 572-RXRX. That's 572-7979.
On Sundays, your NFL team is always playing at Buffalo Wild Wings. With 63 HD TVs having the NFL package, you will not miss a minute of action. Enjoy wings, salad, sandwiches, and more as your teams take the field. Come in and fan up while enjoying the variety of beers on tap from kickoff to the final whistle. Located at 417 Rieger Drive in Williston, North Dakota, football lives here. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beers, sports.
State Mystics and the Williston State Tetons. Tetons trailed by one at the break, 37-36. Tetons went hot for to start off the game in the final 10 minutes of the first half. They only scored 11 points. Let's see if Coach Herman and company can get it going here in the second. Tetons looking to get after it here as they would love to take their second game of the Mystics and match them in the standings in the Mondak Conference as both teams get prepared to head down the stretch before they have the Mondak Conference playoff at the end of February. And the Tetons are looking to march their way up the standings and see if they can host a home game here for the first game and the play-in game of the conference standings. Set to go, Mystics will have the ball. Starters out for both teams on the court. It'll be Bader, Strand, Brown, Davis, and Bozeman on for the Mystics. Olsen, Ingett, Marks, Best, and Sterling for the Tetons. Davis over to Strand. Gets it to Bozeman, low post, finds Davis. One-on-one with Best. Good move by Davis, and he gets it up and has a bark at the official asking for a foul. Tetons now trailed by three, 39-36. Best has the ball over to Olsen on the far wing. Driving up on top against Brown. On the high post, swings it over to Ingett. Ingett takes off like a shot, kicks it off to Marks. Marks for three for the tie, got it to go! Makai Marks is the ninth three-pointer of the game for the Tetons. And Ingett with a steal in the inbound pass over to Olsen. On the low post, puts it up with the harm. Will Olsen foul on Bozeman? And the Tetons reclaim the lead, taking the first 5 points with a chance to make it six of the half. So Will Olsen and Tyler Ingett coming up big on that possession to steal the inbound pass. Ingett now with two huge steals in the game as Will Olsen at the stripe for one shot. So Olsen, a very good free throw shooter for the Tetons. One of one on the way, and that one is good. Now Tetons up by a triple, 42-39, more full court press. Brown looking to push past Olsen. Olsen's going to be whistled for the foul, and he's calling for a hook from Brown, but the official not buying it. That'll be a quick foul on Olsen. First team foul on the Tetons. First personal on Will. It'll be inbound ball coming for the Mystics. Coach Herman calling for some more on-ball pressures. Olsen comes across the half line. Brown up on top. It goes to Davis. Tetons sink down into their 2-3 matchup zone. Strand has it, looking for action. Little congestion for the Mystics in the paint. Strand now puts it on the deck into the corner for Bader. Davis calling for it on the post extended. Sterling some good defense. Just about a steal from Olsen. Corner three coming from Strand. Up, no good. Sterling comes down to the board. Tetons take control. Chance to extend their lead. Ingett takes a head of steam. He holds it up on top. Olsen for three. Off the mark, no good. Sterling with the rebound. He's going to pump fake, and he'll go all alone up and under, and they're going to call Sterling on the baseline, and he got Strand on the pump fake and fell down. Coach Herman asking one of the far officials, hey, don't you think there should have been a foul on that one? And I can see the official chuckling. So the Mystics may have gotten away with one in the Tetons, coming back with some full court press. Kenneth Bozeman looking to inbound the ball for Bismarck State in a three-point game. 18:39 left to go on the American State Bank scoreboard. Raymond Brown pushes past Will Olsen. He's going to drive. Goes for a little floater over the top of Sterling. And a little bit of a breakdown again on defense for the Tetons as Brown gets the floater to drop. Back up comes Ingett. Over to Olsen on top to Best. Back to Will Olsen. Bounce pass to Rex Sterling on the perimeter. Looking for a guide. Guard finds Marks in the corner to Olsen. Sterling pass posting up. Back to Marks. Sterling fighting hard underneath with Davis. That's a big time battle. Best with a catch and shoot. That's going to be off. No good. And see if they're going to say not touched by Garrett Bader, as that three-pointer didn't catch anything. And they'll give the ball back to Bismarck State. Now just a one-point game, 42-41. Tetons, more full-court press. Look to trap Brown. He kicks it over to Strand. Strand waiting. Here comes Olsen up on him into the corner. It'll go to Davis. Best on him. Three-pointer from Davis. That'll be up. Marks will pick it up, poke it in the air. A long outlet pass. It'll be caught by Bozeman. And Bozeman gets it underneath. He throws it up. No good. Blocked by Sterling. Put back by Davis. Ingett racing up the court. He'll give it to Sterling. Euro step. He's going to push it up, and they're going to call a foul on Brown as he was inside the restricted area. That'll be the second team foul. Brady Feller set to come into the game for Williston State here with 7:35 left to go. And Rex Sterling, who's just had 2 points at halftime, looking to add to his scoring total. We'll have to see if they can't get that big man going from Melbourne, Australia. His three Tetons are set to come in after the first free throw. Sterling at the stripe for the first one. Up and good. So into the game is coming Massey, Leon, and Feller. In for Best, Olsen, and Marks. Second one on the way for Sterling. Up no good. Leon comes away with the offensive rebound for the Tetons. And a three-pointer from Tyson Ingett. No good. Be taken away by the Mystics. Up the court, they get it underneath to Davis. He's going to put it up, reverse layup, up and in. So a run-out results in a bucket for Davis, and we're all tied up at 43 apiece. Sterling high post, holds it over to Massey in the corner for three. Richard Massey, man down, and he puts the Tetons back up by a triple. So the Tetons using some hot shooting from the perimeter again to keep the lead. See if they can keep it the rest of the way. The Mystics have the ball on the far wing in the hands of Gavin Strand. In the corner to Bader. Bozeman calling for it. And there's going to call a push on Sterling. That's going to be number four on him. So that'll be Cam Dowse coming into the game with Sterling picking up his fourth foul. He may see a long stretch on the bench with 16:49 left to go in the game. Sterling with an off night, and he'll have to watch a good chunk of it here from the bench until the waning moments of this second half, maybe until about the 8-minute mark. Bozeman curling around looking for an inbound pass. Brown gets it finally up on top to Strand, drives on Ingett underneath to Elmagary, puts it up and in. Elmagary with the bucket, who just checked into the game for Davis. So Davis getting the break while Sterling is out of the game. Ingett back to Leon. It's going to be just about a turnover on the Tetons, but Ingett's able to catch it back up. Massey pulls it back to the top of the perimeter. Hands it off to Feller. Feller looking to drive. Hands it back off to Ingett, working his way through traffic. Back to Feller from the corner for three. High bounce, no good. Tipped out of bounds. And that'll stay with the Tetons. It'll be tipped out of bounds by Bozeman. 46-45. Tetons up by 1 point. 16-18 left to go in the game. Ingett looking to inbound from his own baseline. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Looking for someone to pop open. No one there. Long pass up on top to Massey. And Massey's going to have it stolen away by Bader. And Bader will lay it up and in and give the Mystics a one-point lead. So turnovers costing the Tetons as they now trail again. Both teams have scored 10 points in the first 4 minutes of the half. Doust has it on the perimeter. Looking for a guard to give it off to. Finds Massey. Another bobble by the Tetons. Into the corner for Leon. Leon takes a three. That one's in there. Freedom Leon for a three-pointer, putting the Tetons back up by two. 49-45. 49-47, excuse me. Brown on the drive. He's going to get into the paint. He's cut off. Looking for someone to dish it off to. Finds Bozeman on the perimeter. Elmagary out on the wing. Up on top. It'll go to Bader. Swings it to Strand. Strand looking to drive on Massey. Bounce pass underneath to Elmagary. He's cut off again. Bozeman up on top. Late challenge. And Kenneth Bozeman knocks it down for three. And that now makes it 49-50. As we have a stoppage on the court. We have a delay of game called on Gavin Strand. So the first warning on that, he tapped the ball towards the stands after the bucket was made. Scoreboard reads 49-49. Bozeman may have had his foot on the line, so we'll go with that. Yambi into the game for the Tetons. Swing pass to Massey in the corner, wide open for three. Off the mark, no good. Long rebound's going to go down to Strand. Pushing it back up. Cross court, he'll go to Brown, working his way through traffic. Tipped away by Leon. Leon brings it back the other way for the Tetons. On the far side of the court, he'll slow things down. Back up on top to Ben Yambi. Yambi to Feller. On the low post to Dowse. Dowse cross court to Yambi. He takes off, gets to the high post, kicks it back off to Leon again for three. Freedom Leon, another three-pointer. And the Tetons back up by three, 52-49. Big-time shot by Freedom Leon. 14:47 left to go in the second half. And a timeout is called by the Mystics. It's a full one. We'll take a full one as well. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
American State Bank and Trust Company of Williston is proud to support area student activities. We salute the dedication of all students involved in sports and other extracurricular school activities. Your hard work and dedication shows in the gym, on the field, and in the classroom. ASB has accounts and services to fit a student's busy lifestyle, too. Check them out at asbt.com. Here to make our community better? That's American State Bank and Trust Company.
Member FDIC.
Your education shouldn't mean putting your life on hold. Wherever you are in life, Williston State College has you covered. With our flexible and convenient associate and associate of applied science programs, you can take classes fully online to meet the needs of your lifestyle. With 13 CTE and 15 academic programs to choose from, our dedicated faculty are here to help you achieve your career goals. Visit WillistonState.edu/apply or call 701-774-4200 to learn more. Williston State College, where the people make the difference.
Triple, 52-49. Hot shooting for the Tetons again from beyond the arc. Have gave them the lead, and Tetons going with some full court press. Inbound play coming. It goes over to Brown. Brown picked up by Yabby. Now over goes to Strand. Feller in tow with him as he crosses the timeline. 14-40 left to go. Strand driving, gets in the paint. Underneath to Elmagary. Wide open underneath. Lays it up and in. 4-2. Mystics back with in one. 52-51. Leon has it up on top of the perimeter. That'll be Yambi. Fowler into the corner to Leon. Leon has it tipped out of bounds by Bozeman. They'll stay with Williston State. New substitution coming in for the Tetons. Feller going out. It'll be Olsen coming back in. Leon set to inbound the ball. Couple of big posts in there for Williston State. Yabby driving. He dips it off to Brown, but Elmagary gets a hand on it, tries for a circus pass. It'll be Strand pulling it back out to Elmagary, and there's going to be a travel on Elmagary. Gives it back to Williston State. So the Mystics try to get a little fancy themselves, and dueling turnovers here the last two possessions. 14-10 left to go in a one-point game. Yabby calls out the play, gives some instructions to Leon down the court. And here comes the Tetons into the front court. Yambi on the far wing. Picks up a high screen from Douse. Pulls it back. Hands it over to Olsen. Olsen open three-pointer on the way. High bounce. No good. Tipped up by Elmagary. Saved from going out of bounds by Strand. And it's going to be saved on the ground by Douse. He's going to scramble for it. And there's going to be a timeout call. No. Will Olsen was calling a timeout. And he wasn't given it. And they're going to call a jump ball. Possession stays with Williston State, and now a timeout called by the Mystics. So Will Olsen right in front of the official calling for a timeout, wasn't given it. So it'll be Teton ball here with 20 seconds left on the shot clock. It'll be a short one. We'll take a short one as well. Back in 30 seconds.
So you need a new vehicle. You've done your homework, and a new Honda would be perfect. Reliable, fuel efficient, stylish, perfect. But where do you go? Why not your hometown Honda dealer, Ryan Honda at Ryan Motors in Williston? We have a nice selection of affordable new Hondas, and when it comes time for service, Ryan Honda's authorized Honda Service Center will keep your Honda running its best for years. Come see us today, your full-service hometown Honda dealership, Ryan Honda at Ryan Motors in Williston, or shop RyanHonda.net.
Radio 13:49 left to go in the second half on the American State Bank scoreboard. Tetons up by a point, 52-51. Second half has gone back and forth with a fast start to the Tetons. They got a lead, but the Mystics have been battling back. Inbound pass goes to Massey over to Olsen in the corner to Yambi. Looking down low, Yambi jump stop. He's going to be stripped by Brown. It's a two-on-two break. Brown working his way through. Euro step up, blocked by Massey. Here comes Yambi the other way. Tetons have the numbers. They slow things down, want to set it up in the half court. Massey gets it in the paint. He'll flip it over. Going to be tipped away by Bozeman and the Tetons. Looking to force the issue here, and they're a little bit out of control. Now it's the Mystics with a chance to take the lead this trip down the court. Brown has it. He's curling across the high screen from Bozeman. Gets it into Elmagary in the low post against Douse. Back down. Step move. Little jump hook. Somehow got it to drop. Hussein Elmagary with two more. He's having a good game. And it'd be Best and Mark set to come back in for the Tetons on the next stop. Yabby give and go. Backcourt. It's going to be tipped up by Brown. It's taken away by Strand again. Tetons have had some turnover issues in the half. With a one-point lead for the Mystics, they haven't a chance to extend now. It'll be Gavin Strand on top. He's calling for the play. High, double high screen. Elmagary curls to the paint, working on Doust again. Bounce pass underneath for Bozeman. Locked underneath by Massey. Takes a shot in the face as he's slow to get way back up the court. Leon gets it up to Yambi. Up on top to Massey. Massey, three-pointer straight away, off the mark, no good. Bozeman with the rebound. Back up the court comes the Mystics. 12 and a half left to go in the game. Both teams sinking down, now getting a little more tight here as we march through this second half. El McGarry on the far wing, getting up to Brown, up on top of the perimeter. Waiting for Strand to curl, nothing happening. Now it's going to be a long three-pointer coming in from Strand. That's off the mark, tipped away by Bozeman, into the hands of Dowds, gets it into Massey. Doesn't have numbers, he'll draw it across the half-court line. Get it to Leon, back up on top to Yambi. A couple of Mystics set to come in the game. Will Olsen, corner three, off the mark, no good. Pulled down by Bader. Bader loses the handle, picks it back up. Long pass out to Strand, he's going to have it underneath. He'll have to dribble out. He gets away with the forearm push-off. Over to Bader, off the glass and in. Garrett Bader with the bucket, and there's going to be Coach Herman telling his guys, hey, let's flow within the motion as the three-point lead for the Mystics. Leon on top of the perimeter, marches to the near wing, hands it off to Richard Massey, curls around, up to the elbow. Will Olsen now on the drive, flips it back to Massey. He tries to attack baseline, throws it up, takes a shot from El McGarry, nothing happened. Here comes a two-on-one break. It's going to be underneath the Bader, over the top of Olsen, no good. Going to be tipped around, Brown with the rebound, that's going to be no good. Doused with the board, back come the Tetons, long pass out to Massey. Wide open, Massey gives it up as the Tetons want to take some high percentage shots. Yambi on the drive, kicks it out to Olsen, up on top to Leon, swings it to Massey in the corner to Yambi. Yambi's going to get bumped by Bader, swing pass to Olsen in the corner, he'll take a bump drive, flip pass back to Yambi in the far corner for three, off the mark. El McGarry with the board. Tetons couldn't hit water if they fell out of boat the last couple of minutes as they still trail by 355-52, and a timeout's going to be called on the court by the Mystics. And it'll be one to get some fresh legs in. We'll see if it's a long one or a short one. And it'll be a full timeout called by Bismarck State. We'll be back for more Teton basketball in 1 minute.
When you're looking for a new or a different home, seek the counsel of the professionals at Basin Brokers. Basin Brokers has offices in Plentywood, Montana, Watford City, and Williston. The realtors at Basin Brokers know the market and will help you find the home that fits your requirements and budget. They're happy to answer all your questions about the area. The real estate office you want to know is Basin Brokers in Watford City, Plentywood, and Williston. Find them online at basinbrokers.com. From their humble beginnings in 1910 through four generations, family-owned First International Bank and Trust has been delivering on the promise to help dreams come true one customer at a time. Their style of banking places the focus on you first and your overall experience, keeping your best interests in mind and striving to provide smart financial solutions that improve and simplify your life, letting you get back to what matters most. First International Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Mike, we're back here for Teton basketball. Here at Teton, out on the court, it's going to be Mark's best. Leon Olsen, as well as Yambi out there for Williston State. And the Mystics also made some substitutions. It is Davis, Proctor, Brown has the ball up on top. Over to Davis, finds El McGarry working through. He gets over on the far wing to Strand, crossing over on top against Yambi. Looks to drive, spins in the paint, force it underneath, and there's going to be a foul called on Leon. That'll put Proctor to the stripe for a pair. Look to increase the three-point Mystic lead, 55-52. 10:43 left to go. That's the third on Leon. So now two of the three bigs for Williston State in foul trouble. Leon with three and Sterling with four. First one up by Proctor is up and good. He'll have one more coming at the line. Tetons looking to get out of their stalling downward spiral on the offensive end as Proctor knocks down his second of two. Estel inbound to Massey. Long pass over to Marks. Wide open on the perimeter. Three-point shot from Marks on the way. That one's up and in. Instant offense by Marks. Tetons within two, 57-55. Brown bringing it back up the court for Williston State. Guarded by Yambi. The Tetons still in man-to-man, waiting to back down into their 2-3 zone. High screen coming from Davis. Kicked out. Here comes Proctor. Has it on the wing. Out in the corner to Brown. Little shuffling the feet. Finds El McGarry on the low post. Going to dish it off to cross court. Over goes to Strand. Drives underneath to Davis. Davis going to be put it up. No good. Stolen away there by Leon. Tetons come away with it. Over to Olsen. Olsen, little hesitation move. Gets to get into the body of Strand. Puts it up and in. Will Olsen with a tough shot. A tie game at 56. 7 apiece. Brown works across the half-court line as the Tetons shuffle into their zone defense. They bring it back up and slow things down. Mystics working in the half-court set. So a high screen from Elmagary out to Davis on the wing. Up on top to Elmagary. Over to Proctor. Looking down low. Davis posting up. Swing pass over to Strand. Underneath to Elmagary. Flips it up and in for two more. And there's going to be a stoppage on the court as the ball got kicked down the court. So just incidental kicking, no more delay of games on the Mystics this time. They already have one, so a sequential one will be a technical. Back up the court comes Williston State. Yami over to Best. Best hands it off. No, he's going to fake the handoff to Olsen. Backing down on Strand. Fadeaway jumper, and that one will rim in and out. No good. Good look from Best. Just couldn't get it to drop as back come the Mystics. Looking to extend their two-point lead, 59-57 with 9.5 left to go. Ingot set to check in for the Tetons on the next stop. Davis up on top to Elmagary. Finds Strand on the wing. He's going to fire from range, and that one's off the mark. No good. Tipped down by the Tetons into the hands of Best. Gets it up to Olsen. Two-on-one break. Bounce pass underneath to Yambi. That rolls off. No good. Yambi's going to come back. The Mystics coming back. Strand working his way. Going to be an alley-oop attempted for Davis. That one's going to go out of bounds, and a couple of Tetons now coming in. Grady Gonsorowski will get his first run of the game, and Ingit will come in for Yambi. Also going out of the game for the Mystics is Strand, and coming in is Garrett Bader. Back up the court comes Williston State, trailing by two. Best over to Ingit, now on top to Leon, back to Best, three-pointer on the way, rattles out. Tetons not getting anything to drop besides good shots and looks. Just lipping out several of the last few shots. 8:45 left to go in the game. Raymond Brown on top of the perimeter. Gonsorowski, sophomore. Tough defense. They push it off to Proctor. Proctor on the far wing. Davis on the low post. Gets a step on Marks. And that's going to be Eldick. Elmagary underneath. No good. And it's going to be a scramble for the ball. Elmagary gets the rebound. Gets it up on top to Brown. He heaves one up from range. That's no good. Elmagary again gets gets Leon up in the air and just rims out, but that'll be a St. Elmagary going back to the stripe, and number four called on Freedom Leon, and that'll make Cameron Dowse pop up off the bench and check back into the game. Also, Ian Johnson, who saw just a couple of minutes in the first half, is back in for, or will be checking back in for Williston State after the first free throw. Elmagary at the stripe for the first of two. That one up and in. So it'll be Johnson in for Best and Doust in for Leon. Tetons without a big score on the court with 8:21 left to go. Down three, and Elmagary a chance to make it four. Next one on the way. That one is up and good. He does extend it to a four-point lead. Ingit pushed the ball up the court for Williston State. He'll hand the ball off to Johnson. Works it over in the corner to Gonsorowski. Pull it back out. Tough defense by Brown. And there's going to be a hand-checking foul called on Raymond Brown with 8:12 left to go. 13 foul on Bismarck State. Tetons have four. That's the third on Brown. He's played some big minutes here, and he'll have to be extra careful. Marks gets the ball in on top of the perimeter to Dowse. He's going to take one dribble over to Ingot. Screams around the top of the perimeter and is intercepted, telegraphed it. Here comes Proctor on the run out, and he'll go up and put it in there for the two-point flush. Extends the lead to 6 points for Bismarck State, 63-57. And it's going to be Grady Gonsorowski who will call a timeout for Williston State as the Tetons need to get themselves sorted out before Bismarck State runs away with this one. It's been a tight game throughout. The Mystics have their largest lead of the game. It's a full timeout. We'll take a full one as well. Back in 1 minute.
Of all your choices for a financial institution, clearly the best is the West. Western Cooperative Credit Union is money done the Western way. WCCU provides you with good old-fashioned Western hospitality every time you walk through our door. We treat you like neighbors ought to treat each other, because that's just who we are, neighbors. So head west. You'll know you're here when you see the bison on our sign. Join the herd at Western Cooperative Credit Union, federally insured by NCUA.
McDonald's of Williston is proud to support all the Williston State Teton athletic teams and would like to wish them success this season. McDonald's would like to thank the community of Williston and the surrounding area for your patronage over the years. Hey, the next time you're in town, stop by McDonald's for a great meal or a quick snack. McDonald's of Williston. Breakfast, lunch, or dessert, come on in to McDonald's of Williston. Proud to be a part of Teton Athletics and proud to be part of the Williston community.
By 6 points, they have the ball with 7:53 left to go. Makai Mark set to inbound. He'll get it on top of the perimeter to Tyson Ingett. Ingett working. Gontarowski cutting through, hands it off to Johnson. Johnson gets to the elbow, loses the ball, intercepted by Brown. He's going to take it off to Proctor. Proctor lays it up, misses the mark, no good. Taken in by Ingett. Ingett pushes it up to Marks. He'll go one-on-one with Elmagary. He'll back it down, up on top to Ingett, over to Gontarowski, pump fake three, loses the handle, kicks it over to Mark, baseline drive, spin move, he's going to go, tries to throw a wild one up, nothing there off the backboard, Elmagary comes down to the board, Sterling up to the bench to check in, 7:20 left, Mystics trying to extend their lead, Feller also up to the bench with Sterling, Jones Brown being patient, Davis. Backing down on Marks, a little bit of a mismatch there. Doused on Elmagary, and Elmagary puts it up and in for two more. And the Tetons now find themselves by eight, their largest deficit of the game. Yambi and Massey also checking back in. Johnson from the perimeter, pump fake. He's in a drive, lose the handle on the way up, blocked by Elmagary, who comes back down to the ball. Here comes the Mystics again. Brown slow things down, his time up the court, as four Tetons are set to check in on the next stop. Brown on top of the perimeter, walking his way over to the near wing. Two posts down to the paint for the Mystics. There's going to be Davis with a takes a big bump from Dowse. No good. Elmagary with the rebound. He'll dribble it back out, looking for someone to get it off to. There's Johnson with a big steal for the Tetons. He's going to rip it away for Williston State. Over to Marks on the wing. Up on top to Johnson. Slow things down. Set up the half-court look. Skip pass over to Ingett. Look to drive on Elmagary underneath, and it's going to be a kickball called on the Mystics here with 6:12 left to go, so that'll refresh the shot clock to 20 and a massive line change for Williston State. So now Best also coming into the game for the Tetons. So Tetons go with a line change. It's going to be Sterling, Feller, Best, Massey, and Yambi out there for the Tetons. So Sterling and Yambi looking for the ball, who's looks like it went into one of the tunnels by the court. Now the official picks it up as it everyone lost where the ball was, and now they picked it up and are ready to go. So 6:12 left to go. Tetons trailing by eight. Entry pass gets into Sterling. One-on-one, gets it underneath to Best. Tyler Best puts it up and in to break the big scoring streak for the Tetons. Down to a six-point game. Brown has the ball, guarded by Yambi, working his way up to court for the Mystics. Bismarck State looking to hold on the remaining 6 minutes left to go, and Yambi is going to pick up a foul with the 15th foul on the Tetons, as Brown with a little bit of acting there as he took a soft bump from Yambi. Second personal on Yambi. Tetons still have one more to go before they put Bismarck State in the bonus. Davis gets it into Brown. He'll work his way up on top of the perimeter. Swing pass over to Bader. Bader looking for Elmagary. Nothing there. Now back to Brown. Sterling having to fight tough with four fouls to Davis. Davis working on Best. Crossing over. Now backing down. He'll get a bump and try to swing it. Finds Brown up on top. Four on the shot clock. Brown with a little pull-up jumper. Off the mark. No good. Davis with the board. He'll throw it up, and they're going to call a foul if that one's on Rex Sterling, and thankfully it is, and it's on Tyler Best. But Isaiah Davis knocks down the bucket. He'll go to the line for one. That'll make it now 67-59, and one shot coming from Isaiah Davis at the stripe. Bozeman checking back in for the Mystics. He'll go in for Elmagary, who's had a monster day as he has taken advantage of several Teton mismatches. Looking at this juncture so far in the game, Elmagary has 14 points. Davis has 15 with a chance for 16. No good. Pulled down by Yambi and Williston State. Long pass up to Best. Best working his way around the perimeter. He picks up his dribble, hands it off to Feller. Feller hands it off to Massey. Back to Feller. Fires from the corner. Off the mark. No good. Proctor's going to throw it up to Bader. Save it from going out of bounds. He gets it off to Brown, and back come the Mystics. 5:10 left to go. Brown slowly walks across. He'll be picked up by Feller. Feller, a very strong defender by the Tetons. Now Williston State looking to get some stuff and knock down some shots. Feller working on Brown, just about caused him to lose a handle. Over to Bader. Baseline drive coming. Cut off by Sterling in the corner for Brown. Three-pointer up, no good. Bozeman is going to try to take it down. There's going to be a foul called on Kenneth Bozeman. Bozeman picking up the foul, just his second fourth team foul on the Mystics. 4:48 left to go. Tetons are going to have to start with a little more efficiency here on the offensive end. Best back to Yombi. We'll get it up on top of the perimeter. Sterling, Best underneath, all alone. He's going to throw it up. He takes a shot, no call. And back come the Mystics. Tetons can't believe that nothing was called. And it's going to be Proctor fires it into the corner for Bader. Nothing there. And it'll be out of bounds. Touched out by Best. Kept it away from Bozeman. And there's a substitution coming in for Bismarck State. Into the game, it's going to be Gavin Strand. Out is going Proctor. And we have a timeout on the court. It's going to be a full one called by Bismarck State. With 4:27 left to go, they hold on to an 8-point lead over the Tetons, 67-59. We'll be back for more Teton basketball in 1 minute.
Coke Zero Sugar tastes so good, people will take a taste any way they can. You never know when your best friend will lunge across a table and grab for it. A stranger could subtly swipe it, or your little brother might just ask for one too many sips. So no matter what you're doing or who you're with, while you're enjoying a Coke Zero Sugar, be ready to protect it at all times. Because one sip begs the question, is this the best Coke ever? Take a taste and see.
You don't have to drive hundreds of miles to get a great deal on a new or used vehicle. Price sells cars at Williston Auto. We're in the business of beating the deal from any dealer. Go ahead, shop around from Bismarck to Billings. Then bring us their best deal. We'll squish it like a bug and beat it like a rented mule. No animals or insects were injured while making this commercial. Price sells cars at Williston Auto and WillistonAuto.com. See dealer for the details.
Like it or back here, Mystics inbounding the ball. It's going to be inbound play coming. Mystics made another substitution change, and there's going to be a 5-second call on the inbound pass as Bader came out of the game instead, and Proctor came in. So the Tetons take over. 4.5 left to go. 8-point game. Yombi has it on top of the perimeter. Looking for Sterling down. Bozeman, good defense. Massey takes it on the drive. Kicks it out to Feller. Good closeout from Strand. And there's going to be Feller with a little running layup up and in for Brady Feller. Two more for him. He's up to double digits. Back come the Tetons within six. 67-61. Closing in on 4 minutes left. Proctor has the ball. Calling for a play in the half court set. Here comes Davis on top, as well as Bozeman. Hit a double high screen. Proctor, little fading jumper up. Doesn't hit anything but backboard. Long pass up to Feller. He'll slow things down. No, he'll go for a pull-up jumper, and he'll be clobbered by Davis. No call. Davis comes back up on top. It'll go to Bezos. Davis out to Bozeman. Now on top to Strand. Strand will pull it back out. He'll find Brown along the perimeter. Up on top. It'll go back to Strand. He'll come off on the drive, get to the high post. Second effort, nothing there. Out to Bozeman on the near wing. Throws it down, back to Strand, works his way. Finds Davis, is going to be tipped off the hands of Isaiah Davis, out of bounds. And that'll be a turnover on the Mystics now. As a couple of subs coming in, one for each team. Now two in for the Mystics as Feller comes out. Olsen comes back in. And out of the game is going Strand and Bozeman. Coming back in is Bader and Elmagary. Tetons have the ball, trailing by six. Chance to cut it to a 4-point or 3-point game this possession. Yombi, quick 3-pointer from the wing. Got it to go, Ben Yombi. 3-point game with 3:13 left to go. Tetons looking to get some full court pressure. Inbound pass goes over to Brown. Now to Proctor on top of the perimeter. Olsen working on him up the court, looking to recover. Swing pass into Bader in the corner, up on top to Davis. Got away with the travel, works his way underneath to Elmagary. Trying to steal it away is Massey. Scrounford on the ball, is going to be out of bounds. Last touch by the Tetons. Massey couldn't hold on to it, tipped out of his hands. But good fight for the Tetons as they look to hunker down. Now 2:54 left to go in a 3-point game. Brown with the ball, inbounding from his own baseline. Tetons sinking down into the paint. Pass goes up on top of Proctor. El McGarry looking to get it into Davis, working on Bess, and there's going to be a blatantly missed charge on the call, tipped up and out of bounds. They're going to keep it with Bismarck State. With 7 seconds left to go on the shot clock, Tyler Bess took a huge shoulder into the chest from Isaiah Davis. No call on the play. And now Brown will inbound it up on top to Davis. All alone, close out from Yambi for three, and Davis knocks it down, stretching the lead back out to six. Long pass goes from Best over to Yambi. Pushed it up the court, closing it on 2.5. Yambi driving, flip pass over to Massey. He'll work his way up to the elbow. He's going to get it up, hoop, and won't go down, but the Tetons will go to the stripe. That foul will be on Garrett Bader with 2:29 left. So the Tetons, now this may be their final five they run without on the court unless that fifth foul arises on Rex Sterling. It'll be Richard Massey at the stripe. Chance to cut it back down to four. Currently 70-64. That one up and good. Makes it a five-point game, 70-65. Another one coming in for Richard Massey. Best along the half-court line, waiting for a potential runout for the Mystics. If they can tip a rebound out, should Massey miss this next one? Second free throw up, and that one will drop in there. 2-for-2 from Massey. Back down to a four-point game. More full-court press. Here comes Brown. He's going to be corralled. Over to Proctor it goes. He'll scream up the court. He's going to be cut off, and the Tetons just about get it now. 3-on-2 break. He'll be back up on top to Proctor. He'll slow things down, pull it back up. 2:15 left in the game, 4 points between Davis looking to drive on Yambi. Euro steps through the lane, it's going to be tipped out into the corner for Brown. Baseline drive, and Brown's going to be on the end line. Turnover on the Mystics. So the Tetons, chance to make it a one-possession game if they can convert this trip down the court. So Best will inbound it to Yambi. He'll let it dribble, now pick it up, push it across the half-court line. Yambi on the near wing. Doesn't use a screen from Sterling. He'll pull it back out. Good defense by the Mystics. Swing pass in the corner to Olsen. One touch. And a hook pass underneath to Sterling. Spin move. Gets it into Yambi in the paint. Flip shot up and in. Ben Yambi for two more. And Tetons are within two. 70-68. Timeout on the court. And this one is going to come down to the wire. It's a full timeout. We'll take a full one as well. We'll be back in 60 seconds.
G&G Pharmacy, an independent, locally owned retail pharmacy committed to providing you top-notch customer service from their friendly, fast, and knowledgeable staff. Open 7 days a week. G&G Pharmacy offers the convenience of a drive-through window and a traditional retail store. Melissa and Doug toys available at their downtown service drug location. And no more wondering when your prescription's ready. Use the mobile app or receive a text message when it's ready from G&G Pharmacy. 572-RXRX. That's 572-7979.
On Sundays, your NFL team is always playing at Buffalo Wild Wings. With 63 HD TVs having the NFL package, you will not miss a minute of action. Enjoy wings, salads, sandwiches, and more as your teams take the field. Come in and fan up while enjoying the variety of beers on tap from kickoff to the final whistle. Located at 417 Rieger Drive in Williston, North Dakota, football lives here. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beers, sports.
Inbound the ball, full court press, and there's going to be a foul on the inbound pass called by Will Olsen. And Tetons didn't have a foul to give, so that'll be a 1-1 coming for the Mystics. And maybe if they can get Brown to miss one of the two, they'll come up lucky, because Hussein Elmagheri was hiding underneath the basket the full length of the court, and I don't think anyone even on the Mystics team saw him. Brown at the stripe for a pair, 1:46 left to go. Two shots from the line for 1-1. First one is up and good, so we'll have his second coming. Pulls it out to a three-point game, 71-68. Brown again for his second of two from the stripe. Next one on the way. That one is going to be up and in. So 2-for-2 from the line. Yambi gets the ball, brings it back up the court for the Tetons. Cross the timeline. 1:43. Bounce pass underneath to Sterling. Jump stop, puts it up and in. Big points for Rex, as that's his second field goal of the game. Bozeman gets the ball, hounded by Olsen. He's going to be cut away with a carry over on top to Brown, who'll slow things down. Under a minute and a half left to go. 2-point game, 72-70. Big screen coming up on top from Davis. He'll peel out and pick up the ball on top of the perimeter. Elmagary now on the high wing. Looking back out to Davis. Looking underneath. Three forwards in the game. As they get underneath to Elmagary. Back door to Bader. Bader's spin move. Nothing. He's going to have to force it back out on top to Davis. Huge three-pointer. And Davis knocks it down. Isaiah Davis with a deep three-pointer. Makes it a five-point game. 1 minute left to go. Nobby on top of the perimeter. He'll drive around. Up on top to Best. Best three-pointer over the top of Arsman, knocks it down. Tyler Best with a huge three-pointer keeps the Tetons within a bucket. And they're going to call a foul afterwards, I believe. And Davis, who's heated heading to the bench, his coach gave him a little shove. And they're calling all of the players back onto the court. And a timeout's going to be called now for the Mystics, so confusion on what's going on here. It's a timeout call on the court. We're just going to keep it right here. There's no indication on what the call was. So it's 75-73 with 52 seconds left to go. And now one of the officials is at the scorer's bench as the Mystics are... At least Isaiah Davis looks to be a little rattled, so we'll see what's going to take place after that timeout. And now the officials are conferring as they look up at the scoreboard. Tetons have 17 fouls, so any foul they'll get, they'll send the Mystics to the stripe for a 1-1. Now fouls 8 and 9 to do that. The Mystics only with 5 fouls, so they have some to give if it comes down to it, and they have one left to give. If the Tetons have a chance for a game winner, instead they could take a foul to salt more time off the clock. And there is the first buzzer before we get back into play. And this one, we talked about beforehand how the last game went to overtime and was a fantastic one. This one, when it looked like the Mystics were going to pull away, they had a chance to, up to a 2-point lead in the second half. Tetons are back within a bucket. Now they have things all settled and figured out. And now Davis out of the game as they have Isaiah Davis, who's been